Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm recording about MLflow, MLOps. I will show you how to work with two of the well-known libraries to do time series forecasting, which are the Prophet and SKTime. For those that follow my channel, as a requirement, or at least I advise you to see the or to watch the video where I describe how to implement or to set up the MLflow infrastructure in Docker. It's on the channel. In this video, I describe you how to create all this infrastructure that today we will use in combination with these two well-known libraries, with Prophet and SKTime. So in that video, I describe you how to create the tracker, MLflow tracker, the database to save all the metadata for that. In that case, we are using MariaDB, and also the tool to admin the whole the database, in this case PHP MyAdmin. So watch the videos on the channel. Then on is. It's not, you can watch it as well, but this is just continuation of the initial video, where again we described how to set up the whole infrastructure that now we are going to use with these two libraries. Okay, and then as you probably know, and then also discussed it in previous videos, MLflow is integrating fully with several libraries, deep learning, like you can see here, TensorFlow, PyTorch, HugginFace, FastAPI, FastAI, sorry, Spacy, traditional ML, Scikit-learn, SGBoost, Staff Models, Prophet is one of the one of the two that we are going to watch today, and also LLMs. I chose here OpenAI, Anthropic, Mosaic, and more. Also, you can do some prompt engineering and testing here, and also integrating with LangChain. We are covering in all these videos not only how to do experiments in MLflow, how to create infrastructure. Now we are reviewing how to use different libraries in all of the matters or aspects that we can do with the MLflow, like as I said, supervised learning and supervised learning, time series forecasting, NLP, transformers, prompt engineering, LLMs, or fine tuning and LLM. All this stuff can be done, hyperparameter tuning. We will cover an example of the all these tags in these videos and in posterior videos that we will record and upload to the channel. Today, as I said, we will see SKTime and Prophet, two well-known libraries for time series forecasting, and you will see today that using them in combination with MLflow is very easy. Well, you obviously you need to know how to work with the library. I give you here some the links to the documentation, so you can take a look to them. If you are not familiar with it, I recommend you to at least read the basics to understand what this kind of libraries do, what is the purpose of the libraries, and to understand at least the basics of the time series forecasting. Again, there are more libraries like this, but this is probably one of the most of the better known libraries for this purpose. SKTime, the first that we will see, is not only plenty of the methods, plenty of the different forecasters, different flavors for those like exponential smoothing, ARIMA, stat forecast, also included. You can work as well here with Prophet mode. Yeah, Everything that you may need to do time series forecasting, you have it here. And it's not if you find something that is not here included, you can contact the team that they will implement it, or they will help you to implement it, or to maybe to reuse one of the original models that they have here. They have some base here, and you have some other that you can personalize for specific functions. So take a look to the documentation, at least to understand the basics. Also, it's important to read the documentation of MLflow, how they do the integration with the particular library, because some of them you need to have the specific version of Python, of MLflow, and also SKTile. You need this integration just to guarantee yourself that when you are running the experiment inside the MLflow block, everything is going to be logged. It's not, you can use whatever you have, and if you do it that way, you follow the guidelines and use the libraries that they recommend, you can use autolog. If not, you still can use MLflow, but you will have to log everything yourself. So you will have to deactivate MLflow and log the model yourself, the tables or the metrics, the parameters you want to log in MLflow. You still can do it, but you cannot use in that case autolog, because probably there is a problem, incompatibility problem. Also, we will take a look to pyfunc. This is a Python framework that also is implemented in MLflow, and is giving us a common interface to work with any model, any model from any library. So the only thing that we need to, I would say, respect is some formats. We need to use as well. Where is this? One of these. A library to capture the signature of the data, the input data, and also how the model is going to produce what is the format of the output of the model. So we will see this in Prophet, which is easier than in SKTile. SKTile is I would say custom integration with MLflow. I wanted just to see you because it's a very, very well-known library in the for this purpose, but it's not probably integrated at the same level that is Prophet of others. But in any case, you will see how in you can use it in the really exactly the same way that that other models in MLflow. Okay, what we do here is just we set the tracking URI as usual to, in this case, localhost 500,000, which is, oh sorry, 5,000, which is the port where is the MLflow APIs is listening to record any activity that we may record in the MLflow infrastructure. We provide a name to the experiment. The name, the experiment sheets, just print the experiment sheets, and it's creating a new experiment. In this case, as I already run it couple of times, we will not. You can see here there is different experiments, so we will get just experiment sheets. In your case, if you execute this at your own, you will get the you will not get this message. So now we load a dataset. The SKTile comes as well, like many other libraries, with dataset sample datasets. Also come with specific methods to train to split the datasets. As you probably know, you cannot split the dataset in time series forecasting exactly like we do with a supervised learning problem because you need to respect and to keep the order of the data. If you break this rule, well, you invalidate your experiment. You cannot use data in the future to train a model and then not forecast. So you cannot use, for example, this data set is just a series of 16 observations from 1947 to 1962. So this means that when you split these series, you cannot use data, for example, in the future, or new data to predict data in the past. No, you can. So you need to respect. You split this data set. It had to be, for example, in this case, we will split it in two sets. One is train, and then it will be the first part of the series. And test, it will be the latest observation on the series. You can split using a ratio, for example, by default, temporal train test split come with 25% for testing. So this means that if this series had 16 observations, we will take the four last for test and the 12 the rest, 12 in this case, from 1947 to 1958 at training. So again, and also when you are fitting a time series model, you need to respect always the order. Every observation had to be inputted to the model in the order that is in the series, no? And then on again, you cannot souffle the data as we do in supervised learning. He also you cannot do it when you do cross validation. When you are doing cross validation, you probably remember that we split the data set in folds, and then we take a fold from validation and the other ones for training. Here you can do something similar, but you need to respect the order. For example, if you create here four folds, you can do the same cross validation, taking the first fold for training and the second fold for validation. This is the first run. In the second run, you take the two folds for training and the third fold for validation. And in the third run, you take the three first folds for training and the last fold for validation. So this is something particular for time series, and you need to respect it. You need to keep it, you need to do it like that. It's not you invalidate the whole process, because again, you cannot use data in the future, in a time series, or new data to predict all data. And so all the models, all the methods that usually comes with these libraries are already aware of that, so you don't need to worry. So you use like here train temporal split, it will be doing exactly like I described you here. So this data set is just five regressors in the model, which provide an observation. This is the target, and then we had five regressors that produce every target. So if you do it like that, temporal train test split, it will do it exactly the same. Let's check it out here. If you want to just confirm, maybe we can do here in a and you will see that what I'm telling you is for example, yeah, we can take e-train. You can see here is, and if you take whites, you have the other ones. Okay, this is our general rules for those that are familiar with the time series forecasting. I'm not saying anything new. For those that are new, it's the first time that this is the first thing that you need to know when you are working with time series. So here we load the data set. This small data set is one of the examples. We make the splitting, we create an instance on night forecaster. It's one of the many we have here. We can use others. It's just an example. This is not the purpose of to teach you or to show you how it works scaling. I want to show you how work in how you can use it inside MLflow. Once you fit the model, SkyTank has an interface very similar to scikit-learn, so it's doing a fitting here. You get here the parameters, exactly the same as in scikit-learn, and then you use prediction. In prediction mode, you just pass a forecast horizon, and here we want 4 lakhs in the future. We are going to produce a prediction for these 4 periods, and then we will calculate metric based on the original prediction and the forecasts, the predictions that we are going to generate with the model that we train here. Keep in mind that it's very, very small data set, this one, and then we cannot make miracles here. So we calculate 2 metrics here, MAE and MAPE. And we lock parameters and metrics to the model, and here we lock the model as usual. Here we just create a class here in this file just to grab everything, all the MLflow logic to lock the model, to save the model, etc. It's just a wrapper. I will pass you later on this as well to use it in your local environment. I will upload everything to to the repository, and then we just get here the URI to later on load the model using the 2 different flavors. So here I just want to show you as well how to lock a plot into the into MLflow. Just here matplotlib, we generate a figure. You need to lock a figure with a name, and this will be later on registered in your artifacts section in your experiment in MLflow. Here you have the model URI. As you watch the previous video, we are using the file system. The file system is just, in this case, a pointer to a self folder that could be a file server, or it could be also a mapping of a bucket in S3 or in Amazon or in Google, whatever you had. It's just a reference when you serialize to a file system. You need to use file semicolon triple slash home. This is the URI, the root where I had all the experiments, and the name, the number of the experiment, or sea, the ID of the experiment and the ID of the run, and then on always under artifact models. Let me show you here, probably. Let me show you here how it looks like in the data lake. If you take here and you go to my home, Linux Debian, this is MLflow, and you can see here ML runs. You can see ML runs 6. And now the experiment ending in 54, artifacts, model, and the image. Okay, let's take a look now. Well, let's make the inference now. So you can load the model 2 flavors. One is Using the class, Everflow, flavor again is just a wrapper. I did to encapsulate the skatime class, skatime class. Exactly. And then you can load the model like any other model, any other flavor, and then you just pass the jury, and you can use as well PyFund. PyFund is a is a is standard class that you can use to load any model in Everflow. Any model that you have integrated with Everflow, you can load it with directly with this. The only thing that you need to respect is that you need to create a data frame for with some of the parameters, the same that you are using in the conventional predict or predict interval. Predict interval is a method just for SkyTime, but usually when you make when you use another library, you have predict, and then to this predict you pass some parameters, the same that you pass to that predict, you have to create a data frame to use it with the PyFund. And also pass the data in NumPy format. So we create here two models. One is how to say standard SkyTime. Save it with the SkyTime class, and the other one is this generic PyFund model. So we have two. We create a NumPy array from our test data. Test data, remember that is the 25 percent of the data situated at the end of the series after doing the temporal train test split. We create a forecasting horizon of four observations. We use the predict interval method. We pass the coverage. This is the confidence intervals. We want to get observations with a 90% of confidence in interval confidence and a 95 interval confidence, and we pass the data. And yeah, observe here we load with the loaded model. So this is the SkyTime class of Everflow. We do predict interval. This is what you have to pass to the PyFund, and you pass as parameter the forecast horizon, the data as PD as data frame. No need to pass it in an NumPy array, and you pass the interval confidence to in the parameter coverage. We get here the four observations, the lower band and the upper band at 90% interval confidence, and the same for 95 confidence interval, lower and upper band. And this is done with the model that we load from the Everflow SkyTime, and it loading with the PyFund. You just use predict, and you use the data frame, and it's observed that in the data frame you had to it had to contain the method that you are going to use. If there is a method, particular method, it's not predict method, it will be equal predict. In this case there is parameters like the forecasting horizon, coverage, and the data. The data again, if you use PyFund, had to be in NumPy arrays. And you can observe here PyFund is exactly the same data that we have with the other model. And then let's take a look to this on the on Everflow. Here the parameters, the metric we log. This is what automatically was captured by Everflow using Autolog. This is what also produced Autolog, and this is what it was producing. The model was produced by Autolog, and the plot that we save into Everflow, into the experiment. Okay, let's move now to Prophet. Prophet is a very, as well, very famous library. It was done by Facebook long ago already, and yeah, it's really one of the most used on the for this purpose on the industry. So you will see it's very, very, very easy to use, and obviously integrated with TensorFlow. Yeah, it's fully integrated with them, and you can see that how it works. It's quite easy to use it. In any case, I give you the link to take a look. Just the same that I told you with SkyTime, take a look to get at least familiar with that. There is plenty of options here, plenty of examples. You can code in R or in Python. Remember that you can code as well in R in MLflow. There is a possibility to code in R, Python, Java, or use the REST API. Case that you are not using one of these three languages, you have the SDKs in these three languages, and in case of the Prophet, you also can use R. There is an implementation in R. Okay. Again, there is some dependencies. Keep an eye on that. Optional, if you want to do plots, you need Plotly, and for the TQDM, you need IPY widgets. If you are working in a notebook. Okay, we do the same. We create struct in URI saying that the previous exercise, the experiment name, Prophet. That's nothing new here. So from Prophet, we import the main class, and also some methods to do cross validation, metrics, performance metrics. And we also, as I told you before, we need to import for this purpose to lock the model and to use it later, and to get more information and metadata about how to input the data to this model for inference, and which kind of outputs we are gonna get. We need to use infer signature. We download some examples from Facebook. Some is a retail sales, whatever, doesn't really matter. It's just a data set. Here we had 293 observations of the it's just the time series is starting. Let me get you head starting the series in 1992, 0101. So they are monthly, if I'm not wrong. And take a look, 92 up to 96. So we had a monthly series here. We had 293 observations, and what I wanted to show you is that what I want to do here is quite interesting. Yeah, the series is ending in 1st of May 216, and now we start out MLflow experiment. We instantiate the Prophet object, the Prophet class, and we fit the whole time series here. We extract parameters from this model. This is coming from with this helper I create here. We pack some metrics to calculate during the fitting. We are gonna do cross validation. As I said before, you don't need to worry. You just need to parameterize the how you want to do the cross validation, but you don't need to care. You need to worry. The method is already prepared to do it in the way I described you before. Calculate performance metrics. Here we extract it to a dictionary in order to log it to Emerflow. We get the history, and here we create a prediction with make future data frame. We are creating a data frame with 30 observations in the future, and this means that we are going to do predictions of 30 days in the future after first of May 2016, and then we will incorporate this to the so we will have in the predictions data frame, we will have the original series together with the 30 new predictions. We pass to the infer signature method the train dataset, which is the model, together, sorry, which is the data frame. You see here we are passing model history. Model history is a data frame which contains these data frames, and we pass the history and we pass the predictions. We lock the model to Emerflow. We use in this case the class Prophet. Like any other algorithm that integrates with Emerflow, you have a class which encapsulates all the functionality that you had available in Emerflow. We lock the parameters to Emerflow, we lock the metrics, and now here in Model URI we just get the Model URI, the URI that points to the model into the file system. Here we just training the model, and here we'll plot the metrics, log parameters, and here the URI of the model inside in the file system. Here we end this experiment, and we create a second one with the predictions, and then we also are going to plot some of the available plots that we had in Prophet. Here we are going to load the model using the Prophet class, Emerflow Prophet, and with that we do a prediction. We create a future data frame with 60 observations. We are going to save this data frame. This is a pandas data frame, what is generated. We save it to local here, and we log it as an artifact. We can say here, for example, data sets. Yeah, we'll see what happened here, and then we have here log figures. Here we create this figure that is the history together with the predictions, and there are these plot components, which is the tendency, the trend, and the seasonality components of the signal. So here with plot components we are making a decomposition of the signal. In this case, as we only are two components, tendency, trend, and yearly, and seasonality, we just plot these two components. You can introduce more components, for example, holiday calendars or custom calendars to specify important events for that specific series. If you are, for example, predicting using some data that visualize, for example, sales of products in a supermarket, they may have, for example, days that they make offers, special offers in some products. You can introduce these as events that the model will have into consideration. And if you do that, later you can get as well these components when you plot the plot component graph or plot. Okay, so here we run a second experiment. We are gonna run it again, and then you will see here, yeah, yes. And now I will see how it looks like. What I wanted to show you is the forecast here, this data frame. You can see here is a pandas data frame. Okay, and then or you take the 60 last observations. Yeah, is starting in 2 of May 2016, which is the day after the last observation of the original dataset. This is why the horizon that we use is 365 days. So this is really why how we set up or configure the forecasting model. Here we are predicting not monthly, we are predicting daily. But this is how we configure the model to do it like this. So what I wanted to show you is just is predicting the model. This is the data frame that is producing after prediction, and then it's producing 60, how long is the data set? Len forecast. If you see here 353 should be 60 plus 293. So the data set that generate the prediction is the history that the model that we used to, so the data we used to create the data frame together with the horizon that we implement here to create. So what when we see make future data frame, if we don't specify anything, we are going to predict daily. You can create a future data frame with observations monthly, yearly, etc., etc. Okay, and as you can see here, as we didn't specify anything, it's gonna be daily and the end observation is 2016-06-30. Let's take a look now how this look like on the, so we had the initial model, this is the fitting, this is everything that the MFrog capture automatically. Here we have the metrics, parameters of the model, components, okay. Model metrics, this is what was captured as well by Autolog, and the artifacts. The model, and as you can see here, using the signature, inferred signature, you had the input, an example of the input, and at the output as well. These models are not registered, and I wanted to show here. On this second experiment, I just provide a name to the run. The name is just predictions with the data that date time of now, and giving a format as a string to the date time, and we use this name as a run name. And you can see here, if you don't provide a name, MLflow create one automatically, and you can see here probably we need to include the time, the hours, minutes and seconds just to identify. So this is the one we produced some moments ago. We don't have metrics, you just had the artifacts, we had the datasets, is under datasets, and you had as well the two plots that we generate. It's not the idea to show you how to use SKTine and Prophet. You can do this. You are really interested, I can prepare some videos apart of this series of MLflow. I just wanted to show you how MLflow integrate with these two well-known libraries for this specific purpose. And as I said you before, I'm doing this series of videos to cover most of the technologies that they are integrated. We will do examples of all these the main technologies that integrate with the MLflow, and then you will see that all of them are all this stuff is pretty similar, at least on the way that MLflow is working with them. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. If you get that point of the video. Well, as I used to say, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Give me a like if you like the video. Share with your friends and colleagues if you think that it could be as well interesting for them. Thank you very much. Bye bye.